Hello and welcome to another episode of the Rugged Medicine YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about fingertip pulse oximeters and a few of the associated pitfalls. Let's jump right into the video. Fingertip pulse oximetry and pulse oximetry in general is a very good diagnostic tool to aid in your assessment and diagnostics in a patient. And of course, when you're deciding to apply oxygen to a medical patient following British Thoracic Society or other guidelines, you need pulse oximetry in order to make that decision. Now, when using a pulse oximetry device, there are of course a few challenges. Challenges vary a little bit between device types. This is a fingertip pulse oximeter, so using one of these is more of a budget range if you use one of these by a manufacturer that I can't even recall what it was. And on the entry level or fairly affordable pulse oximeters, the challenge is that the technology being used is not quite as advanced as in the more expensive pulse oximeters for a few hundred pounds. These ones, as you can see from the side here, still emit an infrared light, and that is how they measure the amount of connections or attachments to hemoglobin as it passes through the sensor. But these budget ones cannot differentiate between carboxyhemoglobin and oxyhemoglobin, so carbon dioxide or monoxide and oxygen being attached. As such, there are a few pitfalls, such as when treating patients with smoke inhalations or exposure to certain gases, because this will just show it as SpO2 reading of 100% and a corresponding heart rate. That of course not being what the patient actually has, but it's just misrepresented by the type of device. Another challenge you may encounter is the fact that patients wearing nail varnish, of course, the light will get reflected off it and you won't get a reading. So all you can do there is just turn the device sideways. The other challenge you may encounter is ambient light, such as UV light from the sun, for example, a lot of bright light coming in from this side with a lot of glare, and that may of course alter the signals received by the infrared receiver and therefore give you a wrong reading. Low batteries may count towards problems as well, but that is fairly unlikely because you'd probably get a low battery warning, and most devices tend to just switch off before it comes to that point. Other points of concern may be shivering or vibration, either from the vehicle itself if the patient's being transported, or if it is from the patient actually shaking, such as having tremors from alcohol withdrawal, seizures, Parkinson's, or other causes. And of course, hypothermia and poor peripheral perfusions are another challenge. So as always, don't treat the monitor, treat the patient. If what you see on the screen doesn't match what the patient is representing with, you may of course make a note of that and must then disregard that information and make an alternative plan.
Thank you very much for watching another episode of the Rugged Medicine YouTube channel. In case you haven't done so, please like, please subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.